So the MVPs have had access to this for ages, but now us scrubs, us nobodies, now get to play with Visual Studio 2026. Is it as good as the classic Visual Studio 2008? We will do a performance test and see if 17 years of hardcore Microsoft engineering has got us a faster IDE than Visual Studio 2008. Let's check it out. First, we're going to install 2008, Visual Studio 2008. Just like the old days. And bearing in mind that this is running on a Mac, yeah, in Windows on ARM, on Parallels, let's actually see if Microsoft's total magic works. Looking good so far. Now, if I rightly remember, there was a really scary guy on the installer here who I still have nightmares, frankly. Let's see if he's still there. Oh my God, it's working. Look at that. Oh, we don't actually want everything, do we? Not all of this is going to work. We don't need C++. We don't need VB. We don't need this. Dot for Skater. They used to bundle Dot for Skater. Can you, tools, unit testing tools. SQL Server Express. Crystal Reports. Oh, this really brings me back, guys. This is beautiful. Right, so let's install. Oh, there he is. Oh, this guy has absolutely haunted me for years. What is wrong with his face? Why is it so symmetrical? This is commonly known as the Visual Studio 2008 setup guy. Wow. He's still going. I'm genuinely quite scared. I used to have nightmares because I used 2008, you know, for my university projects. This was the last thing that did XNA. Right? XNA, do you remember XNA? I used to use Visual Studio 2008 for XNA. And I swear I used to see this guy in my dreams. I mean, he's better, isn't he? Yeah, this guy's much better looking. Oh, we need to bring back stock photos in Visual Studio installers. Seriously, we do. Like, I genuinely cannot believe that this is actually installing. Like, 17 years of compatibility layers. These guys, best in the business, you know. He's back. He's on rotation. And Visual Studio 2008 was the last release that it's actually based on WinForms rather than WPF for its user interface. So it's super snappy. Question is, does this actually work? Can we actually start? Because we're going to do some benchmarking, yeah? Here we go in there. 2008. Look at this. Producted like oh man, brings me right back. Look at this. Visual Studio 2008 is running on Windows on ARM, on a Mac, in Parallels. They never saw this coming. So what we're going to do is create a console app as part of our test. So console application one, we're going to do some timings to see is Visual Studio 2026 actually faster than 2008. Here we go. console.writeline. Hello from 2008. Look at this. Look how fast it is. Man, it's beautiful. No dark mode though. No dark mode. Right. Let's run it, see what happens. Oof, it works. Christmas miracle. Let's run some tests. I would run some tests, but clock needs an update. Yeah? All right. Stopwatch. Okay, so the test is, totally unscientifically, how quick does it take to load this console app project? Go. Bang. That's like 3 seconds. Okay, we'll do the official count at the end. Obviously, what we want to find out is Visual Studio 2026 actually faster than 2008? Let's go. Come on. Now, obviously, this is one of those online installers, so it's going to take quite a while. It's going to have to download stuff. It needs to update itself and so on. Right, so the only thing I care about is ASP.NET development. Don't need anything else. Actually, we'll do Windows Desktop as well. I tell you what, this actually installs way slower than even Visual Studio 2008, so it's not a good start. So far, it's launching. Come on, please be faster than Visual Studio 2008 running on something like running on multiple layers of emulation. Obviously, we're going to go dark theme, yeah, because we're cool. Create a new project. we're going to do that console app, just like 2008. Console app, next. And console.readline. Oh, was it read key we did, wasn't it? Read key. Let's run it. Look at all this GitHub Copilot stuff. Probably can't see this here. Look at all this guff on the right. Press this button. Look, all of this. Straight up, shameless, shameless, shameless. Okay. Do we have our console app? Hello from 2026. Connect your GitHub Copilot account. No. Even before the Solution Explorer on the right, it brings up GitHub Copilot. Unbelievable. Okay, so what we're going to do is open File Explorer. Okay. All right, ready, go. Double click. Insiders. This is not good. This is not good. 6 seconds, 7 seconds, 8 seconds, 9 seconds, 10 seconds, 11. What is it doing? How have we advanced? Even 2008 was like 3 seconds to get here, yeah? Loading document contents, and there we have it. I will do the scientific count in a second, but I mean, was that just a fluke? Was that a fluke? Let's close it. Close it. Restart. Go. Double click. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20, 21, 20, 20 seconds. Wowie. Wowie zowie. So what were the scores on the doors for the Visual Studio 2008 console app load? I got 2.5 seconds once I trimmed my recording properly. And for 2026 Insiders, we got a whopping 19 and a half seconds. That's, by my shockingly bad maths, 8 times slower. Wow. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more highly scientific Visual Studio tests. See you next time.